Peeps, what's happening, man? Tony Baker randomly here, man. All right, so I've been in Vegas all week for some shows out there. So I've been staying in the hotel all week. Actually, I've been in the hotel for the past 11 days. Now, when I'm in a hotel, I don't do a lot of channel changing. Like, usually I just turn to one channel, leave it on there pretty much the whole time I'm there, because usually I'm watching stuff on the laptop. But when I'm in the hotel, the HLM channel is what I'm usually on. And you know, they all about crimes and, like, you know, Forensic Files is pretty much on marathon mode on this channel at all times. I'm pretty much watching that channel the whole time. And you know, you get tired of the homicides after a while. You're like, man. But anyway, so they had all kind of stuff on serial killers one day. And John Wayne Gacy, Jeffrey Dahmer, the Ted Bundy joint I missed because I had a show. But like, here's the thing. All right, here's the thing that pisses me off about the whole serial killer thing. People always saying, I never knew. He was so nice, quiet. I never would have thought. He's a nice guy. He kept to himself. He was quiet. Okay, here's the thing y'all need to realize about serial killers, and here's the pattern I noticed. Serial killers don't appear like crazy killers. That's how they get the victims. If you out here looking crazy out the gate, you're not gonna lure nobody nowhere. You know what I'm saying? You're not gonna be like, hey, wanna come back to my place? Come over for some drinks. Nobody's coming over to that. Nobody's pulling up if you asking like that. Hey, just come to my place real quick. What do you say? You know, just have a good time, some drinks. They're charming. They're regular. They seem safe. That's the key to being a serial killer. You know what I'm saying? From now on, when somebody's cool, quiet to themselves, a nice person, I'm automatically thinking you a serial killer. You know, that's always the MO. You know what I'm saying? He was a man about town. John Wayne Gacy, he was part of the community. He used to have parties. He was hands-on. Everybody loved him. Nah, man. You know what I'm saying? Y'all need to start hating me. Because a lot of people are like, man, Tony's mad cool. I need to start acting crazy. You know what I'm saying? Because I don't want to be like, yo, Tony is a serial killer, man. He's just too nice. The cops back in the day was trash. They probably still trash now, but let me tell you something, man. These white serial killers can get away with a whole lot more. You know what I mean? They had John Wayne Gacy. He had already served some time for, like, raping a kid. And so in Iowa, he did time for raping a kid. And then he moved to Illinois, you know, Chicago area, like a suburb of Chicago, not the South Side. Not a lot of serial killers on the South Side. And so, you know, but he was still attempting. He was still, like, assaulting young boys and trying to rape them and all this kind of stuff. And then people would just report, like, yo, man, he tried to get at me, man. He's like, yeah, whatever, man. You just a runaway, man. You know what I mean? It was like, how is he getting away with this? The police was dismissing so much stuff on this man. And these young kids, they coming up like, yo, man, he attacked me. He tried to smash, man. Like, yeah, whatever, kid. You know what I'm saying? And I attribute some of it to, you know, they dismissing it as, like, you know, a gay quarrel or a gay lover's quarrel, or y'all was getting freaky and then it went too far. Now you can't handle it. So they letting them just get away with murder, literally. And I'm just like, what kind of cop work is this? And then all the kids missing in the community, they like, yo, my son is missing. Oh, he just ran away. He'll be all right. You know what I mean? Like, come on, man. Meanwhile, he done killed 33, minimum, 33 kids, man. Y'all had him. Y'all had him. He burying bodies underneath the house, and y'all just like, that's just a regular thing. You know what I'm saying? He's still a nice guy. You know what I mean? He always gets young men over. Like, listen, man. He burying bodies underneath the house. He got people digging holes underneath his crawl space. Yeah, I'll pay you just to dig down. I'm not digging under nobody's house. You know what I mean? Like, come on, man. I'm not digging under your house, creepy man. I'm just like, yo, how y'all letting him get away with this? How? How? And luckily, it was one kid that they wouldn't give up on. Like, yo, this is a regular kid. He was an honor student. You know what I'm saying? He ain't no runaway type, man. My son said he was supposed to meet with this John Wayne Gacy dude about a job. You know what I'm saying? Something ain't right, fire my son. And that's when they finally got on the case after he done went on a murder spree from 1972 to 1978. What kind of cop work is this, man? You know what I'm saying? They would have had my black ass in handcuffs for even giving a cookie to a teenage boy. They'd be like, oh, you buying peanut butter cookies for teenage boys out here, man. Put the cuffs on him. Put the cuffs on him. You know what I'm saying? He out here just living his life. So the cops had this dude. They could have been got him if they were really like paying attention to what was going on. And I get it. It's the 70s. It was a different time. But forget all that, man. Ain't no different time. Even with Jeffrey Dahmer. Jeffrey Dahmer, they should have got his ass on the first murder. Like a cop pulled him over while a dead body was in his car, in the bags, and they let him go. They let him go. They would have had my black ass vehicle searched to the utmost. All I had in the bag was comic books. They just searched all through that mug. They let Jeffrey Dahmer go. And, you know, then his murder spree continued and just it accelerated, you know. And Jeffrey Dahmer, the same thing, man. He was quiet, you know, he was quiet. Nobody would have thought. Jeffrey Dahmer was a quiet dude that lived in an all-black neighborhood. I'm like, what you doing here, though? First of all, not that you can't live there, but like, you know, why are you, usually white dudes don't want to live with us. You know, Jeffrey was luring in young men. It's the young men, it's the gay thing again. One kid got away from him. He ran out of his apartment naked, completely naked, battered up. He was like incoherent. He was almost like, you know, he didn't know what was going on. So to the naked eye, he looked like he was on drugs or drunk, but he's naked in the streets. And you know, the neighborhood's like, yo, there's this boy out here. He's naked. I think he got robbed. Cops pull up. Cops are talking to him. And he can't really, you know, convey, you know, what had happened to him. Because, you know, Jeffrey already tampered with him. And so he's just like, he can't really explain what's going on. So Jeffrey pulls up, drinks in hand. Like, oh, yeah, this is my roommate slash lover, you know. We had a falling out tonight, you know what I'm saying? It was just a wild night, you know. He stormed out butt-ass naked. Ain't nobody storming out butt-ass naked. And he's standing there coming from the liquor store like, yeah, this, you know, this is my boyfriend, lover, whatever. We just got into it tonight, you know, it was a wild night. Why is he butt-ass naked in the community? Explain that. Is that how y'all think gay dudes really get down? Yeah, they just gonna be butt-ass naked in the community, beat up, you know what I mean? They ain't even do a basic background check on Jeffrey Dahmer to see if he had any cases going on, anything, any kind of criminal record, nothing. You know what I'm saying? They let the little boy go back with Jeffrey Dahmer, and then Jeffrey killed him later on that night. See, what kind of shitty police work, man? Let me tell you something, man. The way cops be up, people of color, the way cops be up their ass, they would have never got away with none of that. But Jeffrey Dahmer skated by twice. Twice. John Wayne Gacy just skated by. I'm like, yo, what kind of cops is out here, man? Explain this, man. Serial killers just out here living their best life. Anyway, I'm just pissed off by that because I was watching all the serial killer stuff and it was like, they pulled him over. They let him go. He had the naked kid out there in the middle of the community. They just let him go back with the killer. Like, oh, come on. Come on. That's what we doing out here? And y'all need to realize, man, if somebody's nice, cool, you know what I'm saying, inviting you to the crib, that's a serial killer, man. That's a serial killer. Every serial killer ain't gonna be out here running around butt-ass naked. Serial killers be out here charming it up, man. Y'all be careful out here, man. Tony Baker randomly.